What's up, ladies and gentlemen? I am Dylan, the Techno Giz Guy, and today we're putting a lock on a door, but it's a smart lock. All right, ladies and gentlemen, today I have a special one. So it's a little bit of an unboxing, a little bit of a hardware installation video, and a good bit of a smart video. I bought myself a Yale Smart Lock. We're going to pull it out of the box, we're going to install it, and I'm going to set it up. The smart functionality of this lock is Z-Wave, so it's local. So you guys are actually going to get to see me enroll this in my production system. Hopefully everything goes well. So the lighting is not the best on my workbench, but it's the only space I have currently available to open this box. So we're going to open this box here. Right up top, get some documentation. Well, we're here to help. Get a what you need kind of thing, and I'm guessing the instruction manuals. I actually install really similar locks to these for work, and these are stupid simple, so I'm not going to read the directions. Also, I'm a guy, and it would be a crime against humanity if I actually read the directions first. This is literally just an empty little placeholder, so that's cool. Glad we're really trying to save the planet, guys. So this little module, all of Yale's different products come with these little modules. They come in different colors and whatnot. They plug in. This is the Z-Wave one, so this module will turn this lock into a Z-Wave lock. You can get this exact same lock with Bluetooth, with Wi-Fi, and with nothing. So you could just get a keypad, but we'll talk about that in a second. So here's the little chip that gives this its Z-Wave ability, and here is the front of the lock. This is the part that will go on the outside of your door. There's not a handle on it, but there's one in the bottom of the box. Here is the back part of the handle, as well as where the batteries go. Here are the handles. So you get a key cylinder. These are really easy to swap out with rekeyable cylinders or just a different key. I'm probably going to get this keyed the same as my house key, but for now, this will be fun. You get some door latch hardware, new strike plate, and some screws to put it all in. The only other thing in the box is a set of double A's for the lock. I want to talk about this lock real quick, guys. So no matter what configuration you get these in for smart configuration, they are all the same physically. So they all have a key backup, a keypad, and if the batteries die and you still don't have the key, you can actually jump a 9-volt battery to these two metal contacts here, and it will power the lock long enough for you to put your code in, get into your door, and then replace the batteries. Or you could just keep a 9-volt battery in your back pocket like a weirdo all the time. Whether you get the Z-Wave version, the Wi-Fi version, or the NFC version, you still have the physical backup of a key and a keypad. And if the batteries die, you can still use the keypad using a 9-volt battery. Like I said, I went with the Z-Wave model because I prefer Z-Wave in my home environment. If you guys want Wi-Fi or NFC, you can absolutely go for that. If you just want a fancy lock and you want to save a little bit of money, you can get this same exact lock with no chip. And it will just be a keypad and key lock. Let's put it in. Alrighty, gonna use my LTT screwdriver, not sponsored, not yet. Your setup may be a little different than mine. This is also an interior door. This lock is rated for exterior use, but this is an interior door that I'm putting this on, so I don't have to worry about it being exposed to the elements or anything like that. All right, once you get your screws out, you're just gonna pull the lock front off. Then you'll pull the cylinder back through the back. So it would appear that this fits a standard key cylinder, so that's cool. We're going to put the lock on the front of the door and just kind of let it sit there. Then on the back of the door, we have the back of the lock. So now this plate that came off, you want to actually put this on the door. So that goes on first. But yeah, you want to get this in. And what you want to be careful of is there's a groove here to run this cable. You do not want to run this cable through the center hole. If you run this cable through the center hole, it's going to get bound up in the lock and you're going to break it. I know a lot of guys who have done that for our professional customers, and it's never a fun time. That's in there seated nice. In the little hardware box came a little baggie of these little screws that you can use for the catch plate, as well as there's a single screw for the lock. And you can put it in with an impact. I put it in with a screwdriver because this is a really light wooden door. I'm putting this on backwards. Why weren't you guys going to tell me that I was putting this on backwards? We're going to stick the key in, or the key cylinder, I should say. We're going to get the handle with the hole in it, not the one that doesn't have a hole. And it actually comes with this little tool. They all come with this. This is the handle tool. So it's just this little pin. You can use a screwdriver if you lose it. But what there is there's just a little tiny peg notch here. All right, so that's in. Now we're going to flip back around and actually put the plate on the right side this time. The other thing I've learned from putting a lot of these locks in, because the ones we put in at my job are, they're a little more complicated than this particular one. Something I've learned is it's best to use as minimal power tools as possible, because that's when you'll start binding wires up and motors. All right, guys, after you get the plate mounted out of the hardware bag, you're gonna wanna grab these long machine screws. These go in the holes down here on the sides. They sandwich the lock together. So the plate is screwed to the door. The front of the lock is just held on, and then the plate sandwiches it and pulls it tight. And then the back part will sandwich the plate and the front all together. This one's designed for residential use, so it's a little easier to not screw up. Something I always do when I install these, whether they're the more advanced ones or like the simpler style ones, I won't tighten the two screws all the way down. I'll leave them a little loose so that way you can make sure everything is nice and straight and level. Because if it's not level and you see it, you will never unsee it, and it will bother you until the end of time. At least it will bother me until the end of time. Instead of a screw up top to remove the battery cover, you just like put a pin or like a screwdriver in there and it like comes off. I am not used to that. I'm used to there being a little set screw in the top. On the back, there's one connector here. There's a couple other little connectors, but I'm not too worried about those. We're worried about this big white one. There's a blue line in the center of it. And on the cable, there's another blue line in the center to line up. These are also notched. You can't plug these in the wrong way unless you're really trying to force it. But they also color code it so that way you really can't screw this up. Plug that in, and we're going to flip this around. And like I said, guys, you do not want to pinch these wires, because if you pinch them, you will break them. And if you do that, the lock is basically worthless. This is actually a little nicer than the ones I work with, because this one actually had a little channel to run the wire in, so it's kind of idiot-proof. Now you're going to take the small set screws that were in the box, and we're going to screw those into those two top holes here. They're not that long, and it doesn't take much to kind of get these down. It's just these two screws that hold the back on. And I mean, she's not going nowhere. There's a piece of tape on this that says keep horizontal during installation. The reason for that is because these key cylinders have a little slot that the cylinder fits in. And if you mess this rotation up, it will screw you up and you'll spend an hour trying to figure out what the rotation is that you need to get it to work. Take your other handle, slide it down over, get your little tool, push your little pin in. It's on this side, you moron. And once you hear the click, it's on. So now, congratulations, we have a working door handle, which is exactly what we had before we started. We're going to stick the Z-Wave module in, and I'm going to use the included batteries. But we're just going to put the batteries in here, making sure you keep track of your polarity. You're going to switch every other battery. And it talks, which is a good sign. Pull the cellophane off. All right. It's going to walk you through how to set it up. I'm obviously going to cut out what I just made my pin code, so that way the entire world does not know the pin code into my door. But when you go through, it will ask you to hit the gear icon in the lower corner. You'll hit it, and then you will set your code. And now this door is locked. But I can unlock it, and it'll work. Now it's locked again. So whenever you leave the door, they have this quick little triple tap feature. So when you triple tap them to wake them up, it'll wake up. But if the door is unlocked, it will actually lock the door.
I'm excited.
Okay, guys, so the lock is in. Let me make sure that the keypad actually works. All right, guys, so now I'm going to try to figure out how to add this device. So if I'm correct, then I should just...
Menu mode. Volume system. Wireless module setting map.
Wow, that actually just worked right away. I'm actually a little shocked right now. Like, I have genuinely never seen anything just actually work that well. So let's go down here into Z-Wave. So Yale Assure key lock. Cool. So right now, if we look at the phone camera, I cannot open this door. But if I hit unlock, wow. It's not instant, but it's pretty damn fast. And then I can relock it from the software. Current status of the door is open because I do not have a contact. Okay, so that's it. The lock's installed, works great with Z-Wave. It literally discovered right away in Home Assistant when I went into the lock. So what you do is, if you didn't see, you put your code in, you hit the gear icon instead of the check icon. Then you click the 7 button, which is the wireless network register. I'm guessing if you have the Wi-Fi chip, that's when it'll start asking you to pair with like your phone app or something, because the Wi-Fi chip does need a Yale phone app to do that. None of my videos ever go this smoothly. The lock wasn't expensive. There's a link in the description, of course, as always. If you guys want to add a smart lock to your life, so far this one's pretty good. I will say this, the quality of the Yale products, they're great. They're great quality as long as you don't install them wrong. If you don't torque them down, you don't get the wires pinched up or anything like that. As long as you install it right, they're great products. We've had very minimal problems with them in the company I work for. Overall, this is a great way to add some security and smart security at that. Plus, you have the redundancy of a key as well as that 9-volt little jump trick. And I can unlock this with Home Assistant. And now that it's in Home Assistant, I can set up automations to where when I'm not home, the door is locked. When I'm home, it's unlocked, which is actually what I'm going to do. When I'm not home, the door is going to just be locked. If my family need access to the door, my mom has access to the Home Assistant. Also, I'm putting a code in for her, I'm putting a code in for my brother. And honestly, I could also just set it up to where if any of us are home, the door's unlocked, because I don't care. I have nothing to hide. I just kind of did this as a little bit of a project to see how it would go. Wanted to do it for the video, obviously. And I've wanted to get a lock on that door because I didn't have a key for that door. I figured if I was going to buy a lock, I might as well buy a smart lock. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please leave a like. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. Got all kinds of weird content coming. I really thought this was going to be a more technical video than just like how to put a door lock on. But hey, like I said, all my videos fight me. So this was a huge plus. Anyway, guys, love you all dearly. Thank you for being here. See you in the next one. Keep it peaceful.